And here's Nate McClough leading it off. Hit sharply towards the hole. And Beltre gloves that one.
Boy, it's different when you're playing third base. It's one thing if the ball comes at you fast and you're a hitter because you expect it. It's hard to read it off the bat. You have to have great reactions. That's a great play.
Ball one to begin this at bat, 1-0. And the Braves against the Red Sox, a pretty amazing number. They gave up only 17 runs to Boston.
Yeah, and then they've had a 2-4 record with giving up that little run. But it all goes back to the one thing we talk about is the fact that the Atlanta Braves in 2009 were not a powerful offensive team. Even though they got great pitching, when they played teams with good pitching, they couldn't score.
Lays off that one, misses ball four. One away as Chipper Jones gets set. There's a swing and a liner towards the gap in left field. Base hit, gets it down. That's our first hit of the game for these guys. He'll hold there at second base. Credit him with a double.
Well, that's one of those pitches right there, way off the plate outside, that if you swing and miss at it, you look very foolish. How he got his bat on it, I have no idea. Great bat control, great base hit.
Low pitch from Lester, four ball.
Well, this curveball just drops right off the table. It's a good pitch. Give the hitter credit for not chasing.
Gets through. That run's gonna score. And Jones comes across to score. Base hit knock. And a big one. Brings in a couple of runs.
Well, anytime the guy
swung on, hit sharply to first. To second, there's one. Over to first and safe. Very close play. They will not get the double play.
He makes a nice play to get the lead runner at second base with a strong, accurate throw. Good footwork. They just couldn't get the double play.
The 1-0 now. That one misses. It gets away from the catcher. So they can't make the play.
Well, listen, it's all about advancing base runners in the game. You got to make plays defensively, but that error cost him, and he came out of his hand wrong, and the ball sailed on him.
Here's the pitch. Swung and a fly ball. Now a four-run ball game. They just doubled their lead on that one.
This is all Atlanta all day right now. Braves going to be tough to catch.
0-1.
First pitch is a cutter. Looked at 0-1. And first inning, Steve, we see first inning runs, but this is a whole lot more than that. Big home runs, big lead, a lot of fireworks.
Yeah, you're right. Pitcher's going to have to settle down. He's missing his spots, and boy, they are making him pay for it.
And people, if you're just joining us, that actually is the score, first inning.
Foul ball!
And Gloss, another foul ball.
Well, the battle starts when you step in the batter's box, but the real
line towards second, Pedroia.
Out.
And he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. And so they really take advantage of that first inning pitching. Four runs early. The Braves on top, 4-0. And out on the mound, we'll see Derek Lowe. He'll be the starter for Atlanta. Steve, we'll be watching how he approaches this Boston lineup.
There's nothing overpowering about Derek Lowe out on the mound. He doesn't have an overpowering fastball or slider, but they're effective. He has great movement, and he's awfully tough for the hitters to center. He tries to get them off center on the bat so he gets some weak ground ball outs and get double plays when he's in a jam.
Well, a good start to this inning, but let's see if the guys behind him, after he starts out this inning with the single, can follow up and finish this inning off with some runs.
And Dustin Pedroia up. And Victor Martinez.
And what you love with your leader, your team, Victor Martinez, is the fact that when Mike Lowe needed a break, Kevin Youkilis moved to third base, Victor Martinez went to first base. That just tells you that he's unselfish and all he cares about is winning baseball.
Keeps him close at first. Victor Martinez, tremendous power numbers, RBI producer, a middle-of-the-order guy in a lineup with the Red Sox last year that already was loaded in the middle.
Well, yeah, they're loaded in the middle.
This one's grounded hard up the middle. And there's one. And the deuce, a double play. So no runs on one hit and nobody left on. Atlanta still ahead. Night air surrounding us here at Fenway and the sounds of Boston downtown in the distance. And this is inside. That got him pretty good.
You can't dig in at the plate because sometimes it gets away from the pitcher. You have to be able to move. He couldn't get out of the way there.
And that will bring Melky Cabrera to the plate. Now here's a grounder towards the hole. Up next, Nate McClouth.
0-1 mistake right here. He throws it over the heart of the plate, and he pays for it.
Lined out in his last at bat. And with two strikes on him now, McClouth needs to protect the strike zone. The pitch. Oh, tough one to lay off right there, that fastball. 1-2.
That two-seam fastball is such an effective pitch. One, because it gets ground ball outs, but two, it sets up his other pitches.
Down on strikes there. Nice piece of pitching work. Prado's at the plate.
Now this Red Sox team has been in the mix in the playoffs in 6 of the last 7 years. And with the core talent they have here, they have to have the confidence that they can make it back to the playoffs again.
So Chipper Jones is now going to get a shot at it. Well, the question, of course, for the Red Sox is, yep, maybe make it, but how deep do you go into the postseason?
Well, to me, that's all.
Towards the middle. And he grabs this one. That's one out. Now over to first and safe at first. Close play, not quite enough time to get him. But a quick recovery. There's a swing towards the hole. And that'll put McCann on at first. And Cabrera will score. So the rally here energized every new opportunity they take advantage of. This one swung on and driven hard. And it's going to be Cameron. That's caught. Side is retired. So they pick up a run on 2 hits and they leave a couple. The Braves leading by 5. And Kevin Youkilis to bat. Swung on and hit. This one to McClouth. One away now. And it's David Ortiz in the box now.
Well, David Ortiz, 2009, probably his worst season.
Hit in the air to center field. And he's not able to get there. That's going to one hop off the wall. And he's in at second with a double. 1-0. Certainly a major league pitchers, and I've heard them say this when they look. Hard grounded to short. Picked up by Escobar. And that'll retire Drew. Here's Adrian Beltre with 2 down. Sinker misses badly. 1-0. Pauses, and now the 1-0. A smash towards the hole. That'll do it as they put that one away. And that's another solid inning for Derek Lowe. And he's off to a commanding start. And next, it'll be the Braves getting it going. Looking to the lineup, 6, 7, 8 hitters on their way to the plate. Quick snapshot there, Bobby Cox. He has to be happy with the work on the mound, especially that last inning. Insurance run, so important. John Lester ahead on the count, 0-2.
Well, the hitter lays off this pitch, realizing you can't do much. When you get that kind of four-seam fastball down and away, it's tough to hit.
Yunel Escobar, and he's gone. Strike 3 on a swinging strike.
That's a hard-biting curveball right there with great break. Awfully tough to put in play. Swung right through it.
And Troy Gloss is up. Here's the 1-0. That's high, 2-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone, around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Pitch on the way. Now Gloss has that count at 3-1. Pick a location, go after it. 0-2 lifetime against John Lester. Had a look at that one, but can't come up with it. Troy Gloss looks at strike 3. He's gone.
He just reared back and chucked it. Gave him his best fastball right there. Threw it right at the knees. See you later.
And in the batter's box, it's Ross. He'll try it again. Hit by a pitch as last time.
Ball.
Low pitch from Lester for a ball. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Ball two.
Outside for a ball, and it's 2-1. Here's the 2-1 pitch. That one lofted in the air. It is foul. Still 2-2.
Well, this is one of these epic battles that you just love to see. A pitcher who's not giving in, not throwing anything over the center of the plate, and a hitter who's worked the count even, fouling a tough pitch off to stay alive.
Good defensive half inning there. No hits allowed. Atlanta 5, Boston nothing. We'll get a look at that leadoff hitter due up here in the inning. And Cameron's on the box. And Lowe's pitch. That's not going to be in there. The 1-0 pitch. Swing and a line drive. Gloss able to pull that one in. And we're going to see Scudero here.
Well, Marco Scudero is a very solid player. He's never going to be a star player, but he's going to be the guy that's not going to hurt you no matter where you put him in the infield.
Swung on, and it's hit this one towards McClough. Catch is made. And Jacoby Ellsbury to bat. He singled his last trip, and he starts Ellsbury out. And Lowe's pitch is too low, taken for a ball.
Wow, he had some good bite on that one right there, but the hitter wouldn't chase it.
Picked up by Escobar. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. And nothing across here in this half of the inning. Still unable to score. Boston still a zero. Bottom part of the order will get their chance offensively. And it's Melky Cabrera in the box now. Lester's pitch, a good one, not hit.
Okay, 0-1 count. I'm looking for him to come right back with that fastball.
Melky Cabrera not fooled by that. Count is evened up. Good looking fastball. Called the ball, though, 2-1. And Cabrera works this one to the hitter's count, 3-1.
Oh, it's a great fastball right there, down in the strike zone. Now there's so many ways to go. Let's see how he comes back to attack this hitter.
That brings up Nate McClough.
Well, anytime you get your first hitter up in the inning, big things could happen. It opens up a lot of holes in the deep.
Swing and a ball hit high and deep to left field. That ball is way back there. That'll be off the Green Monster out there in left. Cabrera going for it. And Cabrera will score.
Time.
You want your hitters to go with the pitch. Don't try to force things. The ball's away, he drives it away.
Use the whole part of that plate and the whole part of that bat, and he did.
Kids, you want to learn how to hit, that's how you do it.
It's going to be Tim Wakefield on the mound. He's been chosen to take over out there.
Well, he gets out of the way right there. If he hadn't been, he'd be headed to first base. Sometimes you have to take one for the team.
Wakefield with a windup. Taps this one foul off to the left. Up the middle, Wakefield. That's one. And he's going to hang on to it. No relay, so they will not get the double play.
A tough read for a base runner. You're thinking the ball's going to get through up the middle. You want to score on a base hit. The pitcher snatches the ball, and you're in no man's land. You're out at third.
Around third, he's going to try for it. And he gets there all the way from first.
Well, I tell you what, when this ball left the bat, you didn't think he hit it far enough to be able to get to third base. But boy, once he hit second base, the Jets came on and he gets into third with that triple.
And Ryan McKenna, show no mercy. When the offense is going, you don't give up at bats, and they're not.
It's turning into a rout right now. These guys keep pounding the ball and scoring more and more runs. It's been all about the offense today so far.
Well, he finished that one off with a strikeout. Nice pitch.
That's a great strikeout right there, Gary. Three pitches, and he sits him down. How about that for efficiency?
Floater that time. Misses. One ball, one strike.
Well, and you wonder why a catcher wears such a big glove to catch a knuckleball. Well, there's why. That one stays down in the zone. He had to go get it.
Scudero.
You're out.
Throws to first, side is retired. They pick up 2-3 hits, strand a man. The Braves are just rolling. I don't think they're going to be caught today. Batters 2 through 4 coming right up. We're taking a look at Terry Francona. He's dealing with a prospect of an offense that is unable to get any runs, and that's now been compounded by not a good performance on the mound, especially over the last 3 outs. And that's out number 1 as he takes it to the bag.
But Gary, you know, he's settling into a groove right here. And that's 6.
Here's a swing and a liner to left center. And that'll retire Martinez. 2 away. At the belt, Lowe kicks and throws. First pitch, fastball, 0-1.
Well, they've got a couple hits here, and we're into the 4th inning, so they're starting to get something going. And the second time through the lineup, maybe they'll try to figure something out, Gary.
In there, it's 1-2 now. 1-2 pitch coming. Still 1-2. That one swung on its line. And Youkilis has got himself a base hit. That brings up David Ortiz.
He takes this 1-2 pitch down in the zone. He's able to go down and
swing. A ball hit high in the air, deep to left field. Gone, a 2-run homer.
Now, Boston's been trailing by a lot. This certainly cuts into that deficit, but they've got a ways to go still, Gary.
Hit hard on the ground to short. He'll throw one to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. So they cut into that deficit by a couple of runs. Still a long way to go. Boston, now they're trying to put some pressure on and cut into that lead. And Escobar settles in. That one sails high for a ball. 1-0.
Well, and you wonder why a catcher wears such a big glove to catch a knuckleball. Well, there's why. That one stays down in the zone. He had to go get it.
Here's the 1-1. There's a called strike in the inner half. Now 1-2.
He's getting strikes with his knuckleball. He gets the inside part of the plate right here. At some point, you just have to commit and swing the bat.
And he swings and misses. That is that dancing knuckler. That's out number 1.
Well, credit the pitcher right there. Good 2-strike pitch down and away. Not much he could have done with that, even if he had made contact.
This at bat underway. 1-0 after that first pitch. Grounder up by Beltre. And Gloss retired. And in the batter's box, it's Ross. Took a called 3rd strike in his last time up. First pitch is a knuckler away. 1-0.
Well, he has a lot of confidence in that junk repertoire, and so look for this 1-0 pitch being something crazy.
Towards center field, and that gets down. Ross, a single. And that will bring Melky Cabrera to the plate.
Well, 2 quick outs in the inning, and you think maybe this is one of those quick innings, and the other team gets in and they get some momentum, but he keeps the inning alive with that base hit.
First pitch was a strike, 0-1 now. Gone 6 out of 14 against Tim Wakefield. And in there, 3-for-3 ball game. This a great situation for some offense.
Well, he's having a heck of a day so far. It's his 3rd hit of the game in this one. They just can't seem to find an answer for him.
Wakefield with a windup. Catcher can't control it. On, he's going to try for 2nd. And he just watches that knuckler for a called strike. 2-1.
2 outs in the inning here, but runners on 1st and 2nd.
Lined right at the 2nd baseman. And he gets that one down. His 2nd hit. 2-for-4 today. And Ross is home.
Well, this is getting ugly right now. I mean, he's given up hit after hit after hit. This offense has clearly figured him out. How much longer can you leave him in and take a beating?
Prado's at the plate. Steve, we've seen them continue to charge it up at the putt shot towards the hole. It's through. The runner's going to come home.
Well, they're just teeing off right now. 4 straight hits, and clearly this offense is locked in.
RBI chance. Chipper Jones looking to make hit sharply towards the hole. from his knees, got him. What a throw. So they pick up four hits in the inning and two runs across. The Braves are just rolling. I don't think they're going to be caught today. And it's Adrian Beltre to lead us off. He takes that one, and Lowe has him 0-1.
Gary, he gets a little over-anxious at the plate when the count goes to...
Well hit towards the middle. So Beltre is set down. And Mike Cameron up. Lined out last time up.
Ball one.
And Lowe's pitch is too low. Taken for a ball.
Flat fastball right there. Just missed. Just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
This one's grounded hard up the middle. Picked up by Escobar. So Cameron is retired. First pitch to him. Fastball bounces to the plate that time. And Lowe misses outside, taken for a ball.
Well, to be successful, you've got to keep the ball in the ballpark. And to be successful, have hitters hit it on the ground. That's what his sinker ball does.
And that's in there, 3-1. And that sinker ball will keep a pitcher out of trouble. Keep it out of the air, you got a chance to get out.
Well, it's all about movement. He's got great movement on that pitch.
And he takes that one and misses for ball four.
Good eye by the hitter there, laying off that low ball, understanding below the knees, take it.
Ball one started off the at-bat, hit hard to second. And Gloss picks it up. Throw over to second base, a force to retire the side. And a good half inning there, gone in short order in this one. Braves 9, Red Sox 2. Big bats ready to make an appearance. There's a veteran, Bobby Cox, looking on. Last inning, that pitching gave up nothing. That's what he wants to see. Now looking for the offense to try and expand the lead. Swung on and missed. Behind now, 0-2.
Well, this knuckler's dancing all over the place. It should have signaled its left-hand turn signal as it made that move at the plate.
Rung him up. Strike three. Count that one as a K.
It seemed like he made it easy. Three pitches, big strikeout.
Can't get rid of a guy any quicker than that. Only took three and he's gone. Strike started off the at-bat, 0-1. Matt Diaz has been a player who's been willing to start or, if necessary, come off the bench to get things done for his ball club. Unselfish player. Swing and a line drive. He dives. He's up with it. Throw. Got him. That is one heck of a play. And Escobar ready for the first pitch. Escobar makes contact, fouls it away. Smash towards the middle. The dive, he's got it. And it's in time from his knees to get the out. And a good defensive half inning, three up, three down. And the Red Sox coming up next. And Dustin Pedroia to lead it off. Ground out victim last time through. There's one that's in there called strike.
Well, that's textbook use of the sinker. Down and away, pounding the strike zone. Good pitch.
Back behind first. And Pedroia's got himself a single. And that'll bring Victor Martinez up the hit.
They tried to go down with that 0-1 pitch, but it gets blasted right back for the base hit.
But the way he went after that in the box, Steven, looked like he might have been guessing down there.
Well, I'll tell you what, you have to make contact behind in the count. He got a pitch over the heart of the plate, and he took advantage of it.
One away, and he'll have to hold at first. One down, here's Kevin Youkilis.
Kevin Youkilis is one of these main cogs in the middle of the lineup for the Boston Red Sox. 2009, another outstanding All-Star season. .292 batting average. He hit the home runs. He drove in the runs. He scores runs. But the thing I like about him is he plays multiple positions.
At the belt, the 1-0. In there, we're even at one. For Kevin Youkilis, perhaps most amazing that a player can go from one side of the diamond to the other and be a Gold Glove player at both first and third.
Well, and it gave Terry Francona a lot of flexibility as far as when to rest Mike Lowe after coming off that hip surgery. He could put Youkilis over there, and like you said, Gary.
Swung on and ripped towards second. And Youkilis retired.
Well, he gets the man over to third base, but with two outs now, it doesn't help much, but at least 90 feet closer to scoring.
David Ortiz, big poppy up. The throw. Can't get him. The run scores on the error.
Well, he boot that one and obviously leading.
Now swinging a shot toward second. Throws on to first. Side is retired. They pick up a run on one hit. Nobody left. Boston showing some life. They try to inch their way back. Here's a glimpse of Terry Francona. And tough decisions maybe, or maybe not. This bench needs some inspiration. He'll try to give it to him. Now Martinez spots the pitch. Gloss with a swing and a miss. Pitcher gets it back to even.
That knuckleball down in the zone is so tough.
Drill towards third. And Gloss retired. And in the batter's box, it's Ross. Had a base hit his last time up. Swing and a rocket towards short. And in there, he's 2 for 3 today. And that will bring Melky Cabrera to the plate.
The best laid plans of mice and men often go astray. They shifted to the left. He hit it to the left. The plan just didn't work this time.
He waited on that first pitch and took it. It's hit hard to second. And he'll try to make the play. And two, a double play. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. It's seventh inning stretch time in Boston. Looking ahead, 6 of 8, they're due up. And if you just joined our broadcast, great to have you on board. 2K Sports Major League Baseball, I'm Gary Thorne. Headed for the middle, low. And that'll retire Drew.
A heads-up play by the pitcher. He understands he's a fielder once he lets the...
A smash to first. That's a foul. Here's the 0-1 from Lowe. That's a strike and an 0-2 count. And Beltre now, be careful of the K.
Okay, one out here in the seventh inning. I mean, you have to like the way this is going. They're looking good. The pitcher's throwing strikes. The defense making plays. They've got a big lead. Everything feels good.
And he looks at a called third strike on the slider. Two down.
Well, good late-breaking movement on that slider. Down and away.
Now swinging a shot toward second. Throws to first in time. That's three down. That's called short work of three. Took six pitches. The Braves still on top. And here's Nate McLaughlin leading it off. There's a swing and a smash. And that sets down McLaughlin. One down. Prado's at the plate.
Well, Martin Prado took over the second base job as an everyday player about a month or two into the season in 2009, and he put up some big numbers for the Atlanta Braves. And he and Matty Diaz, once they entrenched themselves at the top of the order, that's when the Braves took off and made a run in the National League East.
Swung on, missed, curveball struck him out, two down.
Well, a great job getting an 0-2. That third pitch, unhittable.
Guess he figured why waste a pitch, save the arm. He did.
Nice job.
And Chipper Jones up. He bounced out his last time. Swung on, contact. This one towards Cameron. And that's out number three. Not a lot of action in this half inning. Nothing on. And here come the Red Sox. Going to be the home half of the eighth. And we're going to see Scudero here. He'll start things off, bottom half, eighth inning.
You know, Gary, I think you're losing a little something here. I don't think this guy's nearly as solid defensively as the one he's replacing, so interesting move.
Good eye by Marco Scudero. He lays off that one, count evened up.
Well, it's getting late right now. They're down a bunch, so they need a big inning here. They can't wait till the ninth to try to come all the way back. They need to try to do something now.
Lowe winds up for the 1-2. Good eye by Marco Scudero. He lays off that one, count evened up.
Wow, he had some good bite on that one right there. But the hitter wouldn't chase it.
Swing and a foul straight back.
The at-bat gets extended. He threw a great fastball right there. Had it in a pretty...
Hot shot towards the hole. And that'll bring up Jacoby Ellsberg.
Well, you wonder he had the energy to run to first base after seeing that many pitches, fouling off pitches, taking tough pitches, but he did. Well, thank goodness he only had to run 90 feet because I'd imagine he was pretty tired.
Here's a called strike.
A good sinking movement on that pitch right on the black away from the hitter. Tough pitch to hit.
Hard grounded to short. Here's a great chance for Boston.
The best hitters in the game use the whole field. You have to be able to go the other way, even when the pitch is over the heart of the plate. That's what he does right there.
Guys prolong their career, not with power, but with base hits that are hit that way. Here's the pitch. Hit hard to second. From his knees, got him. What a throw.
They get the sure out at first base. You'll take the out, but now both runners advance and in scoring position.
And it's Victor Martinez at the plate. Strike one. Starts him out with a sinker for a strike.
Look, Gary, with one out right here, they still have time in this inning.
Swing and ooh, look out. Line drive that shatters the bat. Now it's two down. With runners at first and second, it'll be Kevin Youkilis coming up. Ground out victim last time through. Here's the first delivery to Youkilis.
Ball one.
Missed ball one.
Gary, I think right now that you've got to consider trading outs for runs if you're pitching.
Hit sharply towards the hole. And he'll step on first to retire the side. They get two men in scoring position. Couple of hits. Can't get them home, though. Atlanta's still in charge in this one. And there's a shot of Bobby Cox. He has to be very pleased right now riding this one out. Nice reflexes there to keep that one under control. That one was in the dirt. Here's the 1-0. Line towards second. Pedroia. That retires McCann. And we're going to see Diaz here. 0 for 4 in this one. Hot shot towards the hole. Scudero. That's the second out of the inning. And it's Yanel Escobar now.
Strike one.
Starts him up with a knuckler for a strike. Wakefield with a windup. There's a swing and a drive deep to left field. And there's Ellsbury for the third out. Tim Wakefield, he gets him up and down. 1-2-3. And the Red Sox coming up next. David Ortiz leads it off, and a home run back in the fourth inning. That's it, pretty well down the line and left. That'll be off the Green Monster out there in left. Pulls into second with that double, so he's in scoring position now with nobody out.
But just what his team needed, he continues to swing a great bat. Three hits from now in this ballgame, and he's on with no outs.
And here's J.D. Drew, grounded out his last time through. Two balls, no strikes.
Well, a non-save situation right here in the ninth inning, and they just want to get outs right now. Try to get the first out of the inning. Take away hope. As the other team needs to score a bunch of runs, you get an out, you can really deflate them.
Come set. Swung on, and it's hit. This one towards McClough. That's one away.
Well, obviously, winning big right now, you just want to go out there, make plays, throw strikes, force them to try to put multiple hits together to get back into this game.
Sliders in there, no balls and a strike.
Down, down, down. It's all about location. That breaking ball down in the zone makes it very difficult on the hitter.
Looks at one that's in there, 0-2. It's hit foul by Beltre. The pitch. Tried to get him to chase that curve. It's 1-2. The 1-2 on its way.
Foul!
Another foul ball. Beltre working hard in this at bat.
Well, you know the pitcher wants to get this strikeout right here, but the last thing he wants to do when he's ahead in the count is make a mistake. And the more balls he keeps fouling off in tough.
Well hit towards the middle. That's the second out.
Down to their final out right here, Gary. So, it looking pretty dire at this point. And, but listen, funnier things have happened.
Swung on, hit on the ground. And that'll do it, everybody. That's out number three. This ball game over.
Atlanta with the victory today. They showed up to play, played their kind of baseball. And now a chance to build on some success.
Now we'd like to grant the Pepsi Clutch Performance Award now. Fantastic pitching, and today it was the work of Derek Lowe.
And for our listeners' benefit, and for you also, Gary, I would have liked to avoid some sort of cliche, but it never stops being true. You can't.